ugly crooked smile and blue eyes that were gray when it was raining.
About last night, me talking to Fitz, I know it freaked you out, and I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Well, then what is it? Do you not like my edit on Stalker Angel?
Shh, I'm reading.
Did I add too much? Oh, I did add too much. You hate it. I wrecked your horror story.
Honestly? It's way better. I'm super impressed, Claire.
Really? I'm so glad to hear you say that. And you know, you have nothing to worry about. No one is going to come between us. I promise.
Let's promise to not fight again.
What is going on, Fitz?
You got my emails. Good. Look, I'm concerned about you and Eli.
Stop it. Eli and I are great. And besides, it's not your place to be concerned.
I'm just looking out for a friend.
Where did you get the idea that we're friends? And why are you sending me emails at 3 a.m.? You cyberstalking me in the middle of the night?
No, I wasn't. I was in an internet cafe and I was totally bored.
What were you doing in an internet cafe at 3 a.m.?
It's open all night. I was trying to sleep.
And you can't sleep at home?
Nope, but what do you care?
What about Father Greg?
Just don't worry about me, okay?
I'm just trying to help.
Like you said before, we're not friends.
I know, all of a sudden the skies opened up. Should put you in the mood to finish your horror story. If you finish, you can come over.
I'll call you back, okay? Bye. Fitz?
I have nowhere else to go. I fell off my bike. The road's slick with all this rain.
And you just happened to fall off your bike right outside my house?
I guess so. Can I stay here for a bit?
My mom's not home and she wouldn't like it.
Please, it's raining hard. I won't bug you at all, I promise.
Let me throw that in the dryer. That looks bad.
It was a bad fall. Okay, if I watch some TV?
Just until the rain stops.
Do you have anything to eat?
Stopped.
As soon as my stuff's dry, I'll go.
you're gonna sit here, you're gonna tell me what really happened.
My bike.
The truth, Fitz.
My stepbrothers never really liked me. But since I got out from juvie, it's full on hate. Steve hates everything but the drugs he puts in his pipe.
This is serious.
I'm trying to help him. The more I try, the more he hates me. Today he lost it. Beat me up.
I'm really sorry. But you can't stay here. What about your parents?
I'm the least of their worries. Besides, I'm gonna get through to Steve. Once he finds the path of the Lord, he'll be okay. I changed, so can he.
Let me go check the dryer.
Claire? What did Eli do to get to be with such an amazing girl?
Fitz, you really do need to go now. You have everything you need?
Yes, thank you. Actually, there is one thing. When I was in juvie, I had a special place to go in my mind. You.
Of course. People warned me. They said this was all an act.
What's an act?
Finding God wanting me to forgive you. Is any of this real?
It's all real. Just like my feelings for you, Claire.
Okay, but I love Eli. And Eli loves me.
Eli doesn't love anyone. He's a seriously messed up dude.
Excuse me? This coming from the guy who came at him with a knife.
What I did was wrong, and I admit it. But I've changed. Eli never will, and you know that. Me and you, we have a spiritual connection.
Whoa. Okay, enough, Fitz.
Claire, it's me.
Eli, just one second. You need to go to the book right now.
You are looking at a literary master.
Hey, Eli.
Fitz just showed up on my doorstep all beaten up. He's having problems at home.
Sure, more lies. Why do you care?
Because anyone with a heart tries to help people when they're in trouble.
What are you saying? That I'm some heartless monster?
Sometimes.
Eli, we need to talk.
I have nothing to say to you.
Me and Claire have a special connection.
Call Father Greg to come pick you up. I have to figure out how to clean up this mess.
The sky is breaking up, Jim. Inform my next of kin.
I know you're mad, but just let me explain. I didn't mean it when I said you were heartless.
It's okay. I deserve it. I don't want to lose you, Claire.
You're not going to.
I just feel like you're slipping away and I can't stop it. Don't leave me, okay? Please. Promise me, okay? Just promise me.
Okay.
And I think I'm walking in.
Got something for you.
Stalker Angel?
Never got a chance to read it last night, so I thought you want to go over it before we submit it.
I'd love to. I can't wait to see how it all turns out.
Well, with all the drama last night with you-know-who, the rain and the thunder, it really got me thinking about the ending.
You changed the ending again?
I really think I nailed it this time. The hero, Malcolm, realizes he can never protect his heroine, Rachel, from Stalker Angel. So he has no choice but to...
kill Stalker Angel.
No. He kills Rachel. He grabs his knife, cuts her throat, drinks her blood, and forever they are one.
That's disturbing.
It's brilliant. Wouldn't be much of a horror story otherwise.
Right, of course.
It's my masterpiece. And I couldn't have written it without you. It's all about you, Claire.
Great. Just try not to kill me, okay?
Funny. Don't I owe you a driving lesson? The hearse awaits.
You sure that's a good idea?
Don't be ridiculous. I'll be with you every step of the way, m'lady. I love Claire Edwards. And I think I'm one.